Samalata, Master Teacher of Kakatiya Public School. Today I am going to explain the word sums of multiplications and divisions of money topic. Yes, children, let's do this problem here. Find the cost of three balloons. We need to find out the cost of three balloons. If one balloon cost has given 6 rupees 75 paise, means one balloon cost is 6 rupees 75 paise. One balloon cost has given, children. We need to find the three balloons cost. Okay. And one we know we are finding the more means you need to do here multiplication, children. What numbers you need to multiply here? 6 rupees 75 paise you need to multiply by the 3. When you are finding the 3 balloons cost. Okay. So you need to multiply that 2 numbers. Here this problem is multiplication problem, children. Come on, let's write the steps and let's do the problem. Cost of 1 balloon. Is equals to 6 rupees 75 paise. One balloon cost is 6 rupees 75 paise. Now let's find the three balloons. This is a required statement. Cost of three balloons. Three balloons means the amount, one balloon amount you need to multiply by the 3. So 6 rupees 75 paise we are multiplying by the 3. Let's do the multiplication here. 6 rupees 75 paise into 3. Now 3 5s are 15. 5 1 carry. 3 7s are 21. 21 plus 1 22. So 2 2 carry. 3 6s are 18. 18 plus 2 19 20. So 20. And in the question we have 2 digits before point. So in the answer also we should keep 2 digits before point. Nothing but 20 rupees 25 paise. Okay. The cost of 3 balloons is 20 rupees 25 paise. This is the amount for 3 balloons. Yes, children, let's do this problem here. A bar of chocolate cost is 15 rupees 25 paise. Means a bar of chocolate, means one chocolate bar cost is 15 rupees 25 paise. Here I am writing nothing but one chocolate cost is 15 rupees 25 paise. What they are asking? How much money will Aman get back if he buys 3 bars of chocolates and gives 100 rupee note? Okay. He has given 100 rupee note and he purchased with 3 chocolates. Okay. So, 3 chocolates means after giving the 100 rupees, how much he will get back, the amount we need to find. First, let's find out the 3 chocolates cost. One chocolate cost they have given, okay? And he purchased the 3 bars of chocolates now. Let's find the 3 chocolates bar, 3 chocolate bar cost, okay? So, 3 chocolates, one we know and we are finding the more. 3 nothing but more chocolates, you know, here. So, we are finding the more amount, okay? So, we need to do here multiplication. First, let's find the multiplication. Then, we will get the 3 chocolates bar cost. Later, we will find how much he will get back if he give to shopkeeper 100 rupee note, okay? Come on, let's find the 3 chocolates cost. Cost of a bar of, a nothing but 1, a bar of chocolate. So here 15 rupees 25 paise. Yes, let's find the 3 chocolates cost. Cost of 3. Sorry, here cost of a bar of chocolate. A bar of Now, 3 bars of chocolates or 3 chocolates. So, 3 chocolates cost we are finding, children. So, how to find the 3 chocolates cost? 1 we know, more we are finding means multiplication means 1 chocolate cost we are multiplying by the 3 chocolates. Okay. So, 15 rupees 25 paise into 3. Let's multiply here. 15 rupees 25 paise into 3. 3 5s are 15. 5, 1 carry. 3 2s are 6. 6 plus 1, 7. Now 3 5s are 15. 5, 1 plus 1 carry. Now 3 1s are 3 plus 1, 4. And here 2 digits before point, and here also 2 digits before point, we need to keep the point. Now here we found the 3 chocolates cost 45 rupees 75 paise. Okay, 45 rupees 75 paise, the cost of 3 chocolates. But here what they given here, how much money will Aman get back? Back amount we need to find out, children. Already in the previous videos, I said you children, when you are finding the back amount, you need to subtract the amount from the given amount to the shopkeeper. Okay, so to the given amount to the shopkeeper is 100 rupee note. He gave 100 rupee note to the shopkeeper. He'll get back the amount after purchasing the 3 chocolates. Okay, this amount is for 3 chocolates. 45 rupees 75 paise 3 chocolates cost. We need to find out the get back amount, nothing but subtraction. Okay, from 100 you need to subtract this things items, things cost. Come on, let's find here. This is the final step. Hence, Aman get back 100 rupees. So how much first he has given here? 100 rupee note he has given. Okay, 100 rupee note minus the cost of 3 chocolates. The cost of 3 chocolates is 45 rupees 75 paise. You need to subtract 45 rupees 75 paise. Come on, let's subtract in rough column here. Paise are not given in the 100, no, so you can keep the zeros. And here 45 rupees 75 paise. Let's subtract this. 0 minus 5. It's impossible, children. So we need to take the borrow from here. This. If I'm taking the borrow, this one will become 0 and this will become first to 10. And later on, if I'm passing the borrow to mixed digit, so it will become the 9. And here again it will be 10. But we require the borrow here. So I need to pass here again. So here it will be 9 and it will be 10. And if I'm passing this borrow, again it will be 9 and here it will be 10. Yes? Now I require the borrow here. So 10 minus 5. 10 minus 5. Or else you can start counting from the 5 to 10. 5 after 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 5 numbers I require. So 5. Now 9 minus 7. 9 minus 7 you can count, or else 7 you can start counting from 7 to reach the 9. So 7 after 8, 9. 2 numbers I require to reach the 9, or else 9 minus 7 is 2. Now 9 minus 5. You can start counting from 5 to down to up. Okay. So 5 after 6, 7, 8, 9. 4 numbers are required. So 4 here. And 9 minus 4. 9 minus 4 means 4 after you count to reach the 9. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 5 numbers are required to reach the 9. And here 0. Means how much you get back the amount here? 54 rupees 25 paise. Here. That's right here. 54 rupees 25 paise. Okay. See, this is the way to, this is the combination of multiplication and subtraction problem, children. If you purchase the given one cost amount and we need to find out the more cost, and we are finding the get back amount, means first you need to multiply the cost of the things, how many you are purchasing, and that amount you subtract from the given amount to the shopkeeper. Then you will get the back amount here. This is the answer, 54 rupees 25 paise in this problem. Come on, let's do this problem, children. Sheila bought 5 meters of cloth for 235 rupees 20 paise. okay, 5 meters of cloth she brought. Okay, for 5 meters of cloth, this much amount she paid, 235 rupees 20 paise. What is the cost of 1 meter of cloth? So 1 meter of cloth we are finding. In this, what you observed in this question, children, with the previous we observed one given, more we found. But coming to this problem, more meters of cloth they given and we are finding here only 1 meter of cloth. Means more given, less we are finding. Okay. So more given, less we are finding means opposite of the previous problem. Nothing but division you need to do this problem. Okay. You need to divide the 235.20 by the 5. So you will get the cost of 1 meter of cloth. Let's write the steps and let's do the solution. Cost of 5 meters of cloth. How much they are given here? 235 rupees 20 paise. Okay. Now cost of 1 meter of cloth. ₹235.20 you need to divide by the 5. Come on, let's do the division here. ₹235.20 by the 5. How many digits we need to divide here? See, when you are doing division, first digit you compare with the divisor chain. First digit is smaller than the 5 divisor. So you need to divide in the first step 2 digits, which is 23. 23 is bigger than the 5 now here. So we need to divide 23 by the 5. Will you get the 23 in the 5 table? Come on, let's read. 5 zeros are 0, 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 threes are 15, 5 fours are 20, 5 fives are 25. 25 is bigger than this. So we need to take the before one, which is 25. 4s are 20. So here 3 and here 0. Okay, let's bring down the 5 next digit. Here 35. Will you get the 35 in 5 table? Let's read. 5 zeros are 0. When I am reading the 5 zeros, I am not opening the finger, children. 5 zeros are 0. 5 ones are 5. 5 twos are 10. 5 threes are 15. 5 fours are 20. 5 fives are 25. 5 sixes are 30. 5 sevens are 35. So 7 times we are getting. So 5 sevens are 35. If you are getting any confusion like this when you are reading here, you can write the 5 table beside and you can do also, children. Okay. So 35 here 0, here 0. Let's bring down the next digit. But the next digit 2. But the next digit is point after decimal number, children. So when I am taking the decimal number down, you need to keep the point in the quotient. Okay. Now 5 ones are 5 zeros are 0, 5 ones are 5, 5 is bigger than the 2, children. So we are taking here 5 zeros are 0. 5 zeros are 0. Why? Because bigger one we can't subtract from this no here. So we are taking the before one, which will be smaller than the upper number here. 2 minus 0 2. I'm bringing down the next digit, which is 0. Now 20. 5 zeros are 0, 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 threes are 15, 5 fours are 24 times. So 5 fours are 20. Let's subtract here 0 and 0. And I have finished the digits to bring down. So completed, it will be the remainder and it will be the answer of the question. Nothing but here, the cost of 1 meter of cloth is 47 rupees 04 paise. Yes. The cost of 1 meter of cloth is 47 rupees 04 paise. Keep in mind, children, here whenever they are giving the one amount, one thing cost or one thing value, and we are finding the more things value, you need to do their division. And as well as when they given here more things value and we are finding the one thing value like this problem, so you need to do the division, children. Okay. Come on, let's do the worksheet. Yes, children, I hope you understood which I explained in this video. Come on, let's do the worksheet. First problem, Kushi bought a book for 130 rupees 50 paise. Find the cost of 5 such a books. A book means one book cost is this much, children. Okay, one book cost is this much. You need to find out the 5 books cost. thing, but here you need to do the multiplication. One we know here, one book cost we know, one thing cost we know, and more things we are finding nothing, but you need to do multiplication. Means this problem you have to do the multiplication, children. Okay, and now second problem. Rajini bought 8 ice creams for 48 rupees 08 paise. Okay, 8 ice creams cost has given here 48 rupees 08 paise. Find the cost of one such ice cream here. One ice cream, children. Okay, so you need to find out the one ice cream cost. More we know here, which is 8 ice creams cost, and one we are finding, which is one ice cream cost. Okay, so you need to do here division. Okay, means first problem you need to multiply, children, and second problem you need to divide. Then you will get the answers of the given questions. Thank you.